Welcome to Justice. I'm Judge Jeanine Pirro. Thanks for being with us tonight. And first to my open. So now we're sending troops to Syria. Not combat, mind you, just to train and assist. But the bottom line for me and every military family in America is that U.S. assets are now on the ground in a country where our truth-challenged president pledged they would never be, where our president said it would be a mistake because that's what ISIS would want.
There would be no American boots on the ground. Any action we take would be limited, both in time and scope.
Mr. President, you don't know what you're doing. A little history. In 2012, you said Assad would be crossing a red line if he used chemical weapons. You put the power, the dignity, and the credibility of the United States of America behind that threat. Assad crosses your red line, and you do nothing. And in your never-ending dithering on foreign policy, you say you're going to ask Congress for reauthorization of military action. And then John Kerry, that foreign policy genius, the one who just negotiated the Iran nuclear deal, says to stop a U.S. attack in Syria, Assad would have to turn over his chemical weapons. The Cheshire cat, Putin, pounced on that one and said, I'll monitor the chemical weapons. And when the deadlines aren't met, no one seems to care. In 2014, when ISIS announces its caliphate in Syria and Iraq with Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi as its leader, the one we let out of Camp Buka, now starts beheading Americans, James Foley, Stephen Sotloff, and other Westerners, and then they start killing us. September of 2014, we start a very limited bombing of ISIS in Syria, again with the promise of no troops on the ground. And Mr. President, in September of this year, one day after meeting with you and not telling you, Putin starts airstrikes in Syria. And in your most professorial manner, you pontificate that bombing is not the way to go.
My hope is that as we continue to have these conversations, and as I suspect Russia starts realizing that they're not going to be able to bomb their way to a peaceful situation inside of Syria, that we'll be able to make progress on that front.
And now you're the one sending troops to Syria. But then again, it's not combat. By the way, 10 days ago, Master Sergeant Joshua Wheeler in Iraq to simply assist Iraqi forces who wasn't in combat was killed in combat. Are you schizophrenic? You announced that you're going to send $100 million to the Syrian rebels. Wait, why? Didn't we just spend $500 million training them? And how did that one work out? We got five guys trained and they ran off. Maybe they're going to start the Middle East version of New York's Five Guys Pizza. So let me see if I get this. Almost 300,000 Syrians dead. Russia, your nemesis, gets in the game. The one who thinks so highly of you that he didn't bother to tell you on the day he met you. He just starts bombing the next day. And you don't even sound good. You say Assad must go. Who are we to tell them that Assad must go? You wimp out when he crosses your red line. Your airstrikes are few and far between. And now you're going to stand up like the bully in the schoolyard and yell what needs to be done? Even Russia, when asked if Assad should go, gave a more democratic answer. Quote, let the Syrian people decide within the framework of the political process. So now, after ISIS controls more than half of Syria, more than 300,000 people dead, antiquities and churches and Christians killed, you decide to send ground troops into Syria? Why? How do we even know who we're fighting? So you've got the Assad forces, you've got ISIS, you've got the anti-Assad forces, the Free Syrian Army, you've got Al-Qaeda, the Al-Nusra Front, and tons of different militias, and the Russian Special Forces. And now you want to ramp it up. Why? Why would we put American soldiers in this cauldron of medieval barbarism? Why would we put our soldiers in Russia's crosshairs? And don't tell me that we're in sync with them like your Pentagon official did. Quote, he said, the United States has not informed Moscow about where the American forces will be, but the area where we're planning to place these special operators is not where Russia has struck or would need to strike. How do you know, Mr. President, where Russia wants to strike? Russia is striking the anti-Assad forces that we are now supporting and training. Let's not kid each other. There are jets flying at supersonic speed, chasing other jets, piles of airplanes out there. And remember the fog of war. The one, by the way, that you and Hillary used in Benghazi, that not-so-foggy narrative. But we kill our own in friendly fire all the time in Iraq and Afghanistan. You don't think that Russia's going to seize any opportunity to mix it up with us? After all, they're partners now with Iran and Syria. My fear? Russia and the United States are now on a collision course. Why would you put American soldiers in Russia's crosshairs? Why would you put our soldiers in Syria? You're the one who can't wait to let the terrorists out of Gitmo because you say Gitmo is a jihadist training ground. What do you think going to Syria is going to do? They can now claim that we're occupiers and get a whole new generation engaged in hating us. Why don't you be honest, Mr. President? Isn't this more about your constantly being one-up by Putin? Be careful what you wish for. You may just get it. And it's the American military families who will ultimately pay the price.